So in today's video, we'll be looking at a pretty serious backstage issue between Alexa Bliss, Nia Jax, and another unnamed superstar. So Paige was recently doing a live stream where she brought on some of her close WWE friends on, and they were all talking and telling old stories. Nia Jax was one of the guests. Nia Jax has just made her epic return to WWE television recently after being gone from the ring for over a year. Nia and Paige are extremely close, as you saw on Raw. Nia's new finisher is actually Paige's Rampage finisher. It was a nice little nod from Nia to one of her closest friends that's no longer able to compete in the ring. After Raw, Paige revealed that Nia did ask permission for the move, and Paige absolutely granted her the permission for the finisher. Paige complimented Nia on using her finisher and had this to say on Twitter. Never use another person's finishing move unless it is given to you. I gave it to Nia Jax, and I have chills. Proud moment. So Nia was one of the guests on Paige's stream, and Nia got into some great detail about a serious backstage situation from a few years ago. From the details that Nia gave, this story sounds like it took place in mid to late 2018. Alexa Bliss was on top of the roster as Raw Women's Champion at the time, but it was clear that WWE was ready to crown Ronda Rousey as the new Raw Women's Champion. So that's exactly what happened. Ronda Rousey dominated Alexa Bliss and became the new Raw Women's Champion. And this is around the same time frame that Nia gave us for her story. Nia told a story on how Alexa Bliss was working with a certain somebody and was constantly getting hurt, and Alexa didn't want to speak up and say anything to management. That's when Nia stepped in and helped Alexa during this really rough time for her. Here's what Nia Jax had to say courtesy of Paige's live stream. She was working an angle, and she was continually getting hurt in a certain angle with somebody. I remember her not saying anything specifically because she wanted to be a team player. She was so nervous, and she wanted to be a team player. Me, personally, from the outside looking in, I was so angry. I was like, no, she cannot do this anymore. I personally would not allow her to get back in the ring to get hurt again. I had to go to the higher-ups, and I had to put down a certain foot and say, listen, Lexi is 5 foot nothing, 100 pounds, getting thrown around like a rag doll and injured every night. I was like, put me in. I'm 6 foot, 300 pounds. I can handle it. I understand there's a certain thing of being quiet and taking it and being like, no, I want to be a team player. And there's another side where it's like, I can't allow to see one of my good friends who I want to see be here in 5 years, like getting hurt. I need to stand up and be there for her and make sure that her livelihood is going to be okay when she's done here. So Nia Jax obviously didn't mention the name of the superstar that was being reckless with Alexa Bliss, but it's pretty obvious to guess who it was. I saw some people talking about Sasha Banks possibly being the superstar in question here, but that's obviously wrong. People are just assuming that because of Sasha and Alexa's history with each other. But Sasha wasn't the one being discussed here. Nia mentioned that this person was tossing Alexa all over the ring, and Sasha has never done that to Alexa. The superstar that Nia is talking about in this story is obviously Ronda Rousey. Ronda Rousey wasn't doing it on purpose by any means, but that's just how her in-ring style is. She's just really rough. So she was throwing Alexa all over the ring recklessly when Alexa couldn't really handle it. Alexa Bliss was concussed by Ronda Rousey a handful of times within a short period of time. Alexa was just recovering from her first injury at the hands of Ronda Rousey and returned during a live event house show. But her opponent that night was, once again, Ronda Rousey. So on that same night that Alexa was making her return after missing several weeks, Alexa was concussed by Ronda Rousey for a second time. And it seems like this was a breaking point for Nia Jax. In Alexa Bliss's 365 documentary from the WWE Network, Alexa even comments on how Nia helped her that night. Alexa had this to say during that documentary. I was crying and the doctor said, I think you are concussed. That's when Nia, you know, stepped in and said, I'm going to call your mom and tell her you're going home. You're staying with me tonight. I'm driving you. And she kind of just took me under her wing that night. So it looks like that night was when Nia Jax had saw enough. She cared for Alexa Bliss that night and shortly approached WWE management after that live event show. You can understand why Alexa didn't want to say anything. You don't want to refuse a match and refuse to work with somebody. That does sound a bit wrong, but Alexa's situation was way more serious. WWE was about to put Alexa Bliss into early retirement because they just didn't know what was happening with Alexa getting hurt all the time. And this whole thing started to make Alexa look bad as well, because everyone was looking at her if she was beyond delicate to be facing these injuries every single time she wrestled. So this story was most definitely about Ronda Rousey and what was happening to Alexa Bliss during those matches with Ronda. Alexa is really lucky to have a friend like Nia Jax that was keeping a close eye on the situation and decided that enough is enough and put an end to Alexa getting in the ring with Ronda Rousey. Who knows if Alexa would have been able to make it back to the ring if she had another encounter with Ronda Rousey. So Nia stepped in at the right time and pretty much saved Alexa's pro wrestling career. So for today's bonus story, we'll be taking a look at John Cena's first message. Since his loss in the Firefly Funhouse, that seemed to be hinting at his retirement. Was this John Cena's final match in the WWE? Let's swap over and take a look at that story. So interesting message there by John Cena. There's just no way Cena will retire in a match that wasn't even a physical match and a match that wasn't in front of a live crowd. Cena just can't go out like that. So it's safe to assume that we'll get at least another big match out of John Cena once the crowds and everything else resumes to normal. But what are your thoughts on Nia Jax's backstory about Alexa Bliss and John Cena's hints about his retirement? Leave your comments, don't forget to subscribe with all notifications on, and leave a like if you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, guys.